Good morning, everyone. Today, the topic we are going to discuss on this online class series is on Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica is a very important pathogen which causes dysentery in humans. Then, coming to the first more introduction of it, Entamoeba histolytica was first discovered in 1875 by Loach in St. Petersburg, Russia, from a patient infected by dysentery. Aduna akoina Entamoeba histolytica haibasi yamna important ba pathogen amani haiba mahik asina human da dysentery haiba anaba se toali dysentery haiba anaba si koi khong hamba anaba ni adubu magi kena ba haiba bu khong hamba da blood mo on mucus yahali. Then coming to the morphology of Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica haiba parasite asi magi form ahom thona lai. It occurs in three forms. The first form is the trophozoid form, and the second form is the precystic form, and the third form is the cystic form. Then we'll go in deep details about the each morphological forms. First one is the trophozoid forms. The trophozoid form is a irregular in shape, my shape naide. The protoplasm is differentiated into a thin outer layer called ectoplasm and inner granular endoplasm. Har ba trophozoid asi magi outer layer si yamna thin noiba ectoplasm amani aduga manungi kuyom sina endoplasm sini. Endoplasm si gi manung da nucleus yaugani, food vacuoles yaugani, amasung granules yaugani. Then coming to the precystic stage. Precystic stage sina magi kitang rounder or shape oigani aduga magi form tau basina trophozoid sida yawram miba food vacuole sing se extrude mapana thokra matung da magi shape se rounder or shape lakani. Then the last form is the cystic stage. Cystic stage hai basina kwaidegi round or spherical shape oi hai bas shape asi nawi matam early stage da magi nucleus yaugani, chromatidial bodies or chromatidial bars or chromatid bodies yaugani, and a mass of glycogen mass. Chromatid bodies or chromatidial bars haiba sing asi RNA bodies singni, and which is mixed with the RNA binding proteins. And as the cyst matures, cyst in a mature ba matam da chromatidial bodies and the glycogen mass will disappear, and the nucleus will undergo two successive division. The mature cyst is quadrinucleated. Then life cycle of the Entamoeba histolytica. Parasite amana magi life cycle ama complete hoina ba hona bada magi host ani hum darkar lai bayawi adubu Entamoeba histolytica di magi life cycle ama complete ta bada it will complete in one host. So how it enters the body and infects the host, will go in deep about it. First, mature or cyst, see, akoina infected or patient natraga asymptomatic or carrier dagi defecate tau bada magi stool da yaugani. Hai ba kan stool sing si amu ishing da mix tau pa matam da moina contamination tho matung da hai ba contaminated or food or water se thaksila matung da ingest tau rakanda akogi host digi masamam da changrani. From the mouth it will enter the stomach, it will reach the stomach, and from the stomach it will reach the small intestine. Small intestine yoro matung da ngasagi cytoplasm cyst to gi mature cyst to gi cytoplasm do detach tawra ba matung da manung di yori ba nucleus sing du thoglakani. This stage is called the metasis. Then the metasis to the it will undergo division to form 8 nuclei. Masagi mari yauram ba mature singdu azik nucleus nipan yauragani haiba nucleus singdu ki individual cytoplasm amana yomsen gani. This stage is called the metacystic trophozoid. This the metacystic trophozoid stage is the infective stage, which will go and infect the tissues of the colon, which undergoes the necrosis. That's why it forms the bleeding during the defecation. Then some develop into pre-cystic form and cysts, which are passed in the feces to repeat the cycle. Then high but pre-cystic form and cyst form sing say amuk ngasai infected of a patient dana khung ham ba yaur ani hai ba khung ham ba yaur ai ba mature si sing se ato pa host amada amuk chang kra kan da mo gi cycle se amuk repeat ta gani. Then coming to the clinical feature, enta mo ba histolytica sina kamaina akhoi gi miyoi ba da infection kamaina tho an ba ge hai ba duni. Incubation period hai ba di parasites na isa manung da chang kra matung da kayam kuina laira kan da ma gi symptoms sing se isa da ulak ba ge hai ba duni. Incubation period si entamoba histolytica idi telabada numimarinida my dysentery or other symptoms utpa horakani, or it may take longer up to 1 year. Then the feature is that main oimba entamoba histolytica gi infection thokpa gi mainaba feature di it causes the amoebic dysentery. The nakhoi na hana su haijakre entamoba dysentery haibadi khong hambada it contains the feces is mixed with the blood and mucus. Then apart from the intestinal amoebiasis, when the parasite goes and infect other organs, it also causes the extra intestinal amoebiasis. Like number one, it causes hepatic amoebiasis. Hepatic amoebiasis hai badi parasite na chala kanda akhoi liver da infect aur matung da mana hepatic amoebiasis se to angani. Then second, the pulmonary amoebiasis. Parasite na nasagi chat kra matung da amuk lungs infection to ma matam da pulmonary amoebiasis to anni sidai sida akhoi na lokhuba matam da brown sputum yohan gani. Then the last one is the cutaneous amoebiasis. Then skin da to anba infection ni. Then last, the laboratory diagnosis. Akoina entamoeba histolytica si infection tho matung da kamaina laboratory da diagnosis ta gani hai banine. Diagnosis ta una bai damak ta akoina karam karam ba specimen dar ka lai. First da, if it is a dysentery patient, then we have to take the stool sample. And if it is the extra intestinal amoebiasis, intestinal na ta ba dysentery na ta ba to pa infection tho ando ewe taradi. If it involves the liver, then we have to take the pus sample. If it infects the lungs, then we have to take the sputum sample. Tissues from the ulcers will also be taken. After the sample has been taken, sample lora matung da akoina laboratory da nasaigi poraiba sample sing do phajana detect au gani moi sinse criteria phajana suna yaura bra yengani a yaura matung da akoina microscopic and microscopic examination taugani. Microscopic examination haibadi stool da laura matung da stool lugi kari morphology ke laibake haibadu khoina mitna naked eye ni yeng badu bu microscopic observation kawi. Then second da microscopic observation. Microscopic observation haibadi ngasai gi stool sample do laura kanda slide amada we in two separate slides we have to make one saline mound and one iodine mound. To make the saline mound, add a drop of saline and then mix with the stool sample, then cover with the cover slip and then observe under 40x or the high power objective. And in another slide we have to put a drop of iodine and then we mix with the stool and then observe under the high power objective. Yengba matam da akhoina picture de yauriba sing se u phangani. So the trophozoids and the cysts will be seen under the microscope. Then coming to the treatment of it. Treatment, the drug of choice such as metronidazole, fluoride, tetracycline are administered. And last one is the prophylaxis. Prophylaxis hai badi preventive measures. Akoin entamoeba histolytica se nahandana ba kari kari protection thaurang preventive measures lauga dage hai bada. General prophylaxis is quite important. Oi, hai bada itam samna hai bada good sanitation, clean water supply and food hygiene are required to protect infection from Entamoeba histolytica. Classical Oshilapo discussion Oshilapamatung in a quesata sing that issue moigi mod, moigi apamba views, moigi question hanging ba, gitanjala zageko. Then a question colapa, amtang taminasi col, amtang lapa mali.
Madame Gitopic, I say I'm the noai, ado marakta kang the ba mayawe, question amatang jage agatra. What is the difference between amoebic dysentery and bacillary dysentery?
Okay. Then hangaiba question si yamna phajaba question amani. What is the difference between amoebic dysentery and bacillary dysentery? Haiba question si niko. Aduna dysentery haibasi parasite khatangda nate bacilli nasu tho ali. Isam samna Shigella species nasu bac dysentery haibasi tho ali. Aduna magi khetna gada basi ihana ba point number 1 da fever. Fever si amoebic dysentery na nabo obatara di there will be absence of fever, but in case of bacillary dysentery there will be presence of fever. Then second point the stool dugi odor magi manam. In case of amoebic dysentery the smell of the stool is very offensive yam nanam thigani, but in case of bacillary dysentery it will be less offensive. Then in third point the na color of the stool. In case of bacillary dysentery, the stool color is dark red color, but in case of bacillary dysentery, the stool color will be bright red. Then the fourth point is the nature of the stool sample. Stool sample do it will be mixed with the mucus and the blood, but in case of bacillary dysentery, there will be presence of mucus and blood, but there will be few or no feces present. Then mathangi question amamu atopa dau laitara di amuk tobla pa yagani. Then okay hangbio hangu kari question no
mem ge topic te ge mem question nam dang jage mem how to diagnose extra intestinal amoebasis ki matang da mem na kitang samlap na tapi ba mem.
Okay. Then man hangaiba question jisu yam phajaba question ni how to diagnose extra intestinal amoebiasis dysentery na taba to pa ikka anabada kamaina akhoina diagnosis tawgani habani aduna akhoina hana su discussion topic su hai kare intestinal da dysentery na taba to pa infection su Entamoeba histolytica na tho ali cham cham na habada ihan hambada akhoina liver da su na hali lungs su na hali then skin infection da su kai gumba hai ba sinse infection thok to ai tar di liver da oi bata ra di we have to take the biopsy sample, and if it is the involvement of the lungs we have to take the sputum sample, and if it is the involvement of the lesion of the skin then we have to take pus from the skin hai ba sinse laura matung da koina various method hai badi serological method na akoina diagnosis taugani like ELISA method or an inhibited hemagglutination method na akoina diagnosis taugani ngasi gi oina Entamoeba histolytica the discussion taubat class ngasi goinde loire mathangi class ta amu unarasi. Thank you.